The Mama Take Heart podcast with Rabrina Rettle is brought to you by Life Audio and is a part of our Faith Toolkit series. For more inspirational, faith-affirming podcasts, visit lifeaudio.com.
Welcome, listeners, to episode one of Mama Take Heart, Understanding Your Gen Z Girl. I'm Rabrina Rettle, a wife and mother to a 17 and 19-year-old. And my desire is to mentor and learn alongside you in this journey to help you be the gospel-centered, compassionate, and influential voice in your girl's life. I've been through the roller coaster of emotions, the social media mishaps, the friendship fiascos, also anxiety, depression, and yes, bullies. I've also seen the growth, joy, and affirmation and hope. And I'm here and I hope to help equip you and empower you with resources and practical takeaways. Today, we're going to take time to learn a little about Gen Z, about who they are, how they communicate, how they see themselves and the world around them, and how they view security both in the world and as individuals. This generation was born a few years before and right after 9/11. The information I gather to help us better understand is from Access Ministry, that's AXIS Ministry, Barna Group website, and Pew Research website. I'll provide more information on Access Ministry and links to the other websites a little later in the podcast. I'd like to start with a verse from Proverbs 3:13 that tells us that blessed are those who find wisdom, those who gain understanding. Now, we know that wisdom comes from the Lord, and today we're hoping to gain insight on what's going on in the hearts, minds, and lives of Gen Z, so we know how to empathetically engage with them with the truth and hope of the gospel. I personally believe information should be used to prepare, not to scare. And so we're going to step into the Gen Z world a bit. There is a lot to learn, so let's get started. Gen Z, who are Gen Z? Those born between 1996 and 2015 fit into this category. When it comes to technology, Gen Zers are considered digital natives, so most don't know or remember a world without cell phones. You know, I remember we took a trip because we are a road trip family, and we were on our way to visit family in Texas. And on one of our trips, we stopped at a toy museum. I remember my daughter was about 11 years old, and as she approached a contraption that we call a landline phone, it had to have been from the 70s or 80s maybe, but you know, it had the base with the rotary dial and of course the receiver part that you put to your ear and mouth and the curly cord that connects the two. Well, my daughter picks up the receiver and looked at the dial and asked, "How do I use this?" I explained to her to place her finger in the dial of the number and rotate around to the stopping point. My husband and I chuckle when we realize she has never used this not so modern marvel. While the tech world is a major cultural shift, one that's the norm for Gen Z, smartphones, the internet, and social media became fundamental components of everyday life. There's an app for that. According to a 2018 Pew Research survey, the most used platforms used by Gen Z are YouTube at 85%, Instagram at 72%, and Snapchat at 69%. Now, we'll add TikTok since that is now the latest craze. But at the time, 2018, so Facebook, it is not as popular. Although in this report, it said that Twitter was less popular than Facebook. That may not be the case in 2020. Some use Twitter to keep up with their celebrities that they follow, to be a voice heard in the virtual town square, to get their news stories, as some of the news comes straight from the source. You know what they say, as far as if you need tech support, you just ask your 13-year-old. They are well-versed. Well, Gen Z's ability to create, connect, and consume is a driving force in how they view themselves and the world around them, how they communicate with one another and find community, whether it's gaming or Snapchat or Instagram. When they connect and create, it produces the hormone oxytocin, and that takes over the stress hormone cortisol. This may be one of the reasons why they spend so much time on their screens. Technology affects just about everything, including their relationships, how they sleep, what they buy, their mental health, and their worldview. And as we know, there are aspects of technology that aren't as helpful. And we'll get into that more on an upcoming episode. Gen Zers' identity, who are they? They are the most global and diverse generation to date. According to the Pew Research site, 52% of Gen Zers are white, 1 in 4 are Hispanic or Latinx, 14% are Black, 6% are Asian, and 5% are another race or 2 or more races. However, for them, diversity is not only racial or ethnic, but also gender, religion, and sexuality. And for the most part, they like to spend time with people who are different from them. The majority of Gen Z wrestles with how to be a safe place for others, and they are reluctant to judge or make others feel out of place. As far as education and workforce, for them, most come from at least one parent has a college degree, a home where at least one parent has a college degree. And although Gen Z is the best educated generation, financial security appears to be more important than a college education. They are progressive and unconventional thinkers, so they find knowledge in many different ways, such as YouTube and other creative and instructional video platforms. Many of them are entering the workforce earlier, and entrepreneurship is very important to them. The world, according to Gen Z, their worldview. Many believe being happy is an ultimate goal in life. And as far as societal change, gender identity, and sexuality, those are some areas we're going to touch on here. Many view increased diversity as a good thing for society, as well as interracial marriage. And when it comes to gender identity and sexuality, some Gen Zers believe a male or female label is unnecessary, that it is determined by how a person feels. 35% of Gen Zers know someone who uses gender-neutral pronouns. Now, since the label of male-female is unnecessary, according to them, they also believe that sexuality is non-binary, or what they call fluid, which means that it doesn't really matter who you're attracted to. Now, when it comes to the same-sex marriage, Pew Research again, 48% say it is good for society, 36% say it doesn't make a difference, and 15% say that it is a bad thing. Those who may not agree with the fluidity will still respect those who do. As an overview of what's important from Barna Group, professional and education first, hobbies and pastimes second, then comes gender sexuality, their group of friends, family background, background or upbringing. And so that leaves us this, because that's pretty far down the list. But I want to leave you with this little piece about where you fit as a parent in their world. Although they state that the profession and education and hobbies and pastimes are key components to their identity, half of them say that they look up to their parents. So that is saying that they are still listening. That leaves me hope that we can still speak into their lives. And even if we don't see them actively listening, to know that they hear you. The information that I provided today, Pew Research focuses on society as a whole, and the Barna Group does a good job of comparing society as a whole to Christian beliefs. And then also Access Ministry, which is AXIS, their website states, "We build lifelong faith by helping parents and caring adults talk with their kids about what they otherwise wouldn't, one conversation at a time." And the Access Ministry vision is to see all caring adults equipped with the conversation, discipleship, and cultural translation skills needed to reach the next generation for Christ. I personally subscribe to their cultural translator newsletter that they offer parents. And what I like about it is it stays on top of the trends, and it explains the trends to you and tells you why it is important in the Gen Z world and how to have a conversation about it, or to have a conversation about it, to see where your child stands in the mix. They also have conversation kits and parent guides to help with conversations. Well, I hope this was informational and helpful to you today. If you join us on our next episode, we will continue to learn about Gen Z and their view on security, faith in the church, and how to engage them and speak truth in an empathetic way, how to disciple them in the world that they're in. Remember, God is for you and you're not alone. With His Spirit, you are filled with courage and strength of purpose. So don't fret, Mama. Instead, take heart.
Mama Take Heart is a production of Life Audio and the Salem Web Network. If you liked what you just listened to, would you take a second and leave us a rating in your favorite podcast app? It really does help more people like you find our show. This podcast is produced by me, Kelly Givens, and Steven Sanders, with executive oversight by Stephen McGarvey. You can find more podcasts like this over at lifeaudio.com.